How are you, sir? Living the dream? Hey, Pat.
Regular season. I'm holding the wall up.
No, you're fine.
You're going to keep running.
No. Turn those off. Keep those open. Sunshine laws require sunshine.
They want to keep me going to sleep.
Sunshine laws. Sunshine laws.
You can't, Cindy, you can't see the screen.
Yeah, you're right. Maybe we can see it.
I'm going to swap seats with Brian anyway. I didn't see him on TV. I had a couple of me not being here.
Well, you're closer to the other
thing. Oh, yeah.
And you just,
Nydia,
you know, I'm going to bring a piece of sign next time.
Nydia. Was that you behind me?
I have no idea.
Do that. Reelect. Yes.
Hello, sir. How are you?
Good.
Good.
How are
you? Thanks. Good. Me too.
Could run up the stairs, man.
He's down there. He slides over. Yeah. He's about here. Yeah. Where's your agenda? Your agenda packet.
It's in the corner.
Money.
Got a question. It's not allowed to read anymore. Did you call Jody to see if he can read?
But you're in time. Is it time out?
I'm out. Time out.
You've been in that all your life.
Raise your hand if you have to draft a motion for your day. You? With your special new badge?
That's his panhandle badge.
Panhandle badge. I'd stay on yellow traffic with a boot. I'm on top of that t-shirt on.
I'd like to call the
special called work session of Forsyth County Board of Commissioners Thursday, April 12th at 2 p.m. to order at 2:04 p.m. All commissioners except for Commissioner Amos are here. Just in a different place. All commissioners are present. If you would like, please stand for the invocation of pledge. Dear Heavenly Father, please look in upon us and guide our decisions. Please protect those who put themselves in harm's way, and please help us to consider it just right, the right way, the taxpayers of this great county. With your hands of guidance, I'm sure we can come to some good decisions for the county. In thy holy name we pray, amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Adoption of the agenda. Are there any changes to the written agenda? I don't. Counselor?
No, sir.
County manager? Seeing no changes to the agenda, is there a motion to adopt the agenda as written? Second. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the issue. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign, and that passes unanimously. Items for consideration. Number one, county raw and finished water contracts. Commissioner Bell and Tam, your name is on the agenda.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. You want to say a statement or whatever you did?
I just want to say again, I'm recused myself in this vote at this moment. Discussion and vote.
Is that good enough, Counselor?
It is.
Thank you.
Is that why you wait for the Ethics Board to?
Yes, sir. We're going to
offer an opinion?
Yes, sir. We're going to appeal this to Ethics Board and get an opinion from them.
Okay.
Can Pete have one to even look at? He can look at it. Public meeting.
Of course. Just don't read it.
Just don't speak. All right. Keep it to yourself.
Can I read it?
Yes.
Well, we'll go ahead and get started here. Commissioner Tam and I spent probably the better part of 3 weeks now working on this, looking at different options, talking with the Water and Sewer Department, many different things. So we'll roll this out real quick. What you'll see up here now, this is the current water cost that Forsyth County pays the City of Cumming. You got the raw water formula on the left, finished water on the right. Raw water comes out after a $43.55 a month for operations. Corps of Engineer cost of power. We take that, it's split up based on usage. Then any maintenance and repair based on a rolling 12-month average of use. Comes out to about 10 cents per 1,000 gallons. Finished water, there's been contracts in place since 87. They've been amended several times. Currently, we're at 243 per 1,000 with a 1.6 billion gallon minimum purchase requirement annual. 1.6 billion, which is about 4.4 and some change per day. But it's an annual, it's not a daily or a monthly, it's an annual purchase of 1.6 billion. What permits are, the city had built a 104 MGD, million gallons per day intake. They have a intake pipe below the sluice level of the dam. So no matter what happens with the lake level, we're still going to get water through that intake. They did that 4 years ago. They've probably spent, Brian, what, $18 to $20 million total on this?
Yeah. And at one time, they were using pumps.
Emergency pumps.
In the drought of 07, 10, 08, we were using pumps out there to get the water pumped to the intake.
Yep.
And this work took place when the lake was down. An opportunity there.
Currently, the permit that you'll see up here, Forsyth County has a permit. They're given in two numerics. It's a 14 MGD on a 30-day average. We can peak at 16 MGD within a 24-hour period. City has an 18 and 21. Combined water limits is 32 and 37 MGD, combined city and county.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Are there any other permits required or obtained from any other agencies for this intake by the city or by us?
I don't know. We use the city's intake. It's been used for...
At some point, they were permitted by the Army Corps of Engineers to build the structure because it's on Corps property. So whether or not that's an ongoing permit, I'm not prepared to speak to right now, but they got a permit to build the structure.
So my concern is certainly there is some reason to argue that there is a legal, that the capacity of the system is larger than the legal amount that can be obtained through it by the EPD. My question is, are there any hurdles of any other agency other than the EPD, including the Corps of Engineers, that would throttle the ability to take the full system capacity if it were required by either the city or us?
You mean to get to 105?
Yeah.
Well, I think that's a remain to be seen. I think given recent history, anybody who tries to pull water out of the lake is bound to be sued by somebody.
No, I'm not asking about, I mean, yeah, we can be sued.
Challenged.
I'm asking about permits. Is there anything that we could know up front in the form of a permit that's missing or limiting to the total throughput of the new system?
Well, I mean, the intake was built with foresight, of course. You know, again, I'm not here to sell for the city, but they had the foresight a long time ago to build an intake. When they built this new intake, they had the foresight to go below the sluice level. But it's also built so that it far exceeds the capacity needed today. So what you're asking is, right now we're permitted together, 32 and 37. It's 104 MGD intake. So at some point in time, the county or the city or both would have to get their permits increased to be able to take advantage of the additional capacity. Is that what you're asking?
Well, no, I think I understand that being the case to the EPD.
Do you know of something?
I don't know of anything, but I certainly wouldn't claim that that I have lots of experience in the permitting of water facilities. And I would hate that we go through this and only to find out that there is some other contingency by some formalized branch of government which prevents us or them from utilizing this floor.
Is there a let's clause right now?
I think that's in place. I mean, the Corps gave the permit. That's the irony. The Corps gave the permit to build the facility, to build the structure, and the EPD hasn't given the permit to pull more water out.
But the Corps permitted the construction of that facility.
The Corps permitted the construction.
Well, yeah, I mean, I have a driveway that's legal, and I can drive the speed of light within my driveway, but I won't get to work any faster because there's another agency that, for most of the job, ride to work, throttles my ability to go at the speed of light.
EPD is the one that controls it. I mean, of course, there's a tri-state commonwealth, which we all have to deal with, but I would suggest that we can't stand still waiting for that. We have to continue moving. We still have to provide water to our citizens.
All right, so the assumption here is that from our point of view, we got an increase in the gallons from the EPD, we don't need to then go to any other agency whatsoever for any reason. We can just pull then that new amount of water.
I don't know that I would agree with that.
That's true.
Tim, I think there's a storage agreement with the Corps of Engineers.
You've got the Corps of Engineers limits that the city's got the expired storage allocation contract, and the Corps is not increasing those at the present time until Tri-State Water Warrant
so
is over.
So we get an EPD increase in the permit and a storage allocation permit.
But currently, the expired permit was for 10 million gallons, and right. We are in a position now where we're taking well over 10 million gallons, which was the top end of what is now an expired permit from the Corps.
From the Corps, who gave the permit to build the facility that would be capable of 105 million gallons a day. It's government bureaucracy at its best.
I know, anybody, the nice thing about living out here for damn road is you have so many governments to choose from.
They allowed that, they permitted that structure to be built. That's a fact. Another fact is.
You have that permit?
I didn't bring it today. Go get it.
Well.
I got a feeling.
In terms of due diligence, if there is such a thing as a physical permit.
I can tell you one thing, I can tell you one thing, I can get a copy of a water contract that expires in about 6 weeks. 5 weeks.
I've got that.
Yeah, I mean, we've had that for 20 years.
25.
And that's not, that wasn't really addressing my question.
I don't know how to.
Well, we're hung up, we understand, so why don't we move forward with this? I think that the common sense answer is the Corps is allowing people to pull what they need out of there within their limits. And as soon as the tri-state water wars are solved or settled, you know, there's a lot of people that believe Judge Magnuson's ruling was going to just shut down the southeast, and it was overturned. So, you know, we just got to keep going, we got to keep doing the best we can. And we can't stop what we're doing based on how it's done. So, next slide shows that on our 14 MGD, we got a current usage of 13 MGD per user average. But we do have peak days. You know, you start looking at June, July, and August, and you're going to have those peak days when people are home doing yard work or washing their cars and things like that. Our peak, highest peak day recently was 21 MGD. I believe that that's a comfortable number to use. I think, Tim, you're comfortable with that number for right now. The really great thing is once our water treatment plant comes online, which is any day now, we're going to be able to treat 28 million gallons a day. So we've done a fairly good job, in spite of some of these unknowns, of preparing to be able to treat the water needs of this county. It's not going to be until 2017, till we exceed the 14 MGD anyway. So we've got several years to work through those issues, but we can still meet our peak needs. This slide shows 20-year projected usage is provided through water and sewer. We're using, projecting to use this year 4.6 billion gallons a year. You'll see it equates down to 12.7. That's where the 13 number comes from. When you get to 2031, you'll see that we're projecting to use 8 billion gallons a year. Still, only going to be at 22 on an average, which our water treatment plant should be able to handle, except we'll have to deal with those peak days. If we can ever get to the point where we can build a good cooperative relationship with the City of Cumming, we could conceivably not have to build another water treatment plant, because working with them, we could work get additional water from them to meet those peak days well into 2035, 2040.
What would those costs be for that treated water, for additional water from the city?
Well, I don't know. I mean, I don't know what 2030, 40, 50 is going to bring. Right now, here's what it would be. On a proposed contract, Commissioner Tam and I put together, and I think is going to be reasonably accepted by the city, is that we purchase only raw water. We will no longer purchase finished water or have any purchase finished water commitment from the city and county.
Commitment, but just looking by some of our plants online.
We will ask them for a commitment to us that they provide, make available 6.5 million gallons a day. It's on the next slide.
Okay. This is a kind of a pricing slide. There's no finished water purchase commitment. Some of the benefits is currently we operate on a price structure or a pricing that if there's repairs and maintenance that we have to pay those, this is consistent. There'll be no repair and maintenance cost responsible by the county. However, we will have to pay for pumps if we're going to pull additional water. And additionally, I don't believe, and I think Commissioner Tam, that we could work this out where we don't have to pay the $11.4 million for the intake.
If I may on that one, at the end of this contract, what happens to our ability to put water in it, renegotiate using that pipe all over again, the infrastructure?
Well, the fact is, for planning, Commissioner Levent, we are buying raw water. We have no ownership, we have no stake, and we have no cost responsibilities towards the intake. We have no responsibilities to a potentially unpermitted intake. What we have is we're buying the service of pulling our water out of Lake Lanning.
Our water?
Well, the 50 cents includes the core cost. All the power, well, it's not our water, it's our allocation, 14 MGD. The city has agreed, let me just finish this. The proposal will be a 20-year term on the contract with a 10-year renewal, which is going to give us a 30-year water solution.
All right, let me ask a couple more questions if I may.
Let me just go to the next slide.
I have questions on that slide though.
Sorry, go ahead.
We're paying now on our permit, our 14 million gallons a day. We're paying a wheeling fee that you showed earlier, two slides back, 10 cents per thousand.
Roughly.
This will raise us to 50 cents per thousand for the first 2 years.
Yes.
And then 75 cents per thousand.
Thereafter.
Why the massive increase?
Because we have, I think Commissioner Tam and I both feel that the board was not interested, and I think there was a lot of outcry in the community that they did not want to pay $11.4 million for a facility that we did not
pay. Those figures would pay for that three, four times up.
You can't have your cake and ice cream and icing in the box and the pan that it was baked in, and you know, you can't have it all. You can pay for the water or you can pay for the intake.
All right, so why don't we pay for the intake and pay less for the water and save even more?
Our belief is the
city. That's a good proposition. I think he's in the middle of making a proposal.
Okay.
I'm hoping that we get multiple proposals.
So why don't we move through this?
Absolutely.
Right. Based on the previous slide and the proposal that we put together, raw water will be supplied from the county's 14 million permit. Remaining water will be supplied under a cooperative share agreement with the City of Cumming for water we need additionally at the same rate. So we'd still be paying the 50 cents or 75 cents a thousand for the 14, 17, or 21 MGD that we need. The IGA that I've had structured, Ken, where's Ken? There he is. The wording you'll go through later is that we have the right to as much water as we need, as long as it doesn't damage the city's daily need. Is that
subject to the City of Cumming's ability to meet its own water needs for its own customers.
Right. So, and that's raw water, same cost, straight through. The City of Cumming has also agreed that in the event of some unknown problem with our plant, they will make available to us every day 6.5 million gallons of finished water.
Excuse me. On a 30-day average.
Yeah, on a 30-day average.
Which covers us.
Tim, can you explain that?
Because we don't need to get too cute here. We may have a problem and need finished water. Mm-hmm. So
and vice versa. They could have a problem with their plant.
Absolutely.
That's true.
And we should be able to sell back up for them the rate as they sell enough.
Could be a reciprocal rate. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. But they will make available to us, and there's no commitment to buy this water on our part. The minimum, maximum, nothing. They're willing to have 6.5 million gallons, millions a day available should we need it. At 243, which is
on a 30-day average.
On a 30-day average. You will see that in the cost of the first year, which is a kind of a comparative, the last year we paid the city how much, Tim? 4.2 or 3 million dollars?
Thereabouts.
This would put us at paying 2.3. So $2 million savings. Which you'll see on this slide.
2.3 the first year?
1.9 the first year.
Okay.
You'll see that it goes right on down and grows the more water we're selling, because not only are we saving more on the net, our treatment cost goes down the more we treat. The calculation here for these savings is based on the raw water and our cost to treat compared to the $1.6 billion that we were required to buy. One of the things I would like to offer is a portion of these savings, I'd like to see them returned to residential water users at the term of a 5% discount starting in 2015. That we're saving this money, that we should share this with our citizens. We need to rebuild and pay off some bonds faster.
Yeah, or you can pay down some bonds.
I would think if you want to be totally responsible, you pay the bonds down first.
Well, some of them you can't pay off first. Some of them you can't.
But the ones that we can, we should
try to pay them down, then you truly have the money to return back to the customer.
I would agree with you, except I don't believe we, our bonds will allow them to be paid down that quick. If they could, then I would.
There's some that can't be paid down that quick.
Then we found out. But I would also like to say that as part of this reduced water cost, as part of this reduced water cost that we're going to be getting, that we all are trying to pass on a little bit of savings to our residential users. It's not commercial, it's not resellers, it's only residential, everyday users.
I just want to look at the numbers and understand and be comfortable with that.
It's a proposal. So here's a graph that shows you kind of how the savings stack up. The red line that you see, that is water cost at our current contract. The blue line shows you kind of a visual of the reduced cost of water on this proposed contract. The green portion of the bars is the annual savings, with the purple adding on top the cumulative savings, which you can see will be about $52.7 million over 20 years to our taxpayers. 52.7, that does not include 11.4 that you can tack right on top of that for a $63 million savings over 20 years. $63 million. So again, this is to summarize the proposed contract. And we can entertain any questions you might have.
I have a little spreadsheet here, and at 50 cents a thousand, I show in the year 2012, if you run that contract, you would have spent we would spend over $5.2 million for the city, which is more than we're spending now.
Well, I've got a sheet here that shows 4.646 gallons.
Mine started off at 4.4, so it's close.
4.6 billion at 50 cents is 2.323 million.
Yeah, but we've got to treat it for 0.68.
Well, it does, and that puts our total cost of water in $1.80. That does. I'll give you my spreadsheet here.
What's our total cost of water today? 10 cents plus your 62?
Right now, 68.
Which makes it 68.
But we're showing a net savings off of the 243 that we're currently paying.
You have a lot, even greater net savings, I believe, if you were to purchase your share of the pipe and stick with the 10 cents.
That would make the assumption that the pipe was available.
If we can stay at 10 cents, I would. Even 20 cents, possibly. I would buy out another pipe.
Let's go through this. That's assuming the pipes are sound, Commissioner.
Well, we got a bill from the city.
Well,
I assume
from what we heard, is that this board and a lot of the citizens, not a lot, six of them, eight of them, didn't want to pay the $11.4 million for something we didn't own. Are you suggesting now that we pay that?
Well, I won't own it, though.
It's not for sale. It's never been an option.
How do you know? Let's send it over to us.
It's been told to us over and over. You know, you got to sometimes just accept the answer for what it is.
Let's just send it over in writing.
It's not for sale. I won't send it over. We've been told.
And get an answer in writing. Why not?
Well, Commissioner.
I'm sorry.
It's not for sale, is it?
I don't know. Why don't you send it over? And in 2 weeks, maybe we'll give us an answer. We'll say either it is or it isn't.
Well, my proposal does not include that.
You offered them $30 million for the water plant, right?
No.
Something
I asked. No, I never offered $30
million. He sent an invoice over.
For 11.4.
11.4, 36, 450, 13.
Okay. Respectfully, I think we're getting off topic here.
Well, not necessarily, because it's in there, and you
know,
I think you finished your proposal, did you not?
Well, we're answering questions, and we're answering your question.
My question.
My proposal is not included because I've been told the intake is not for sale. My proposal does not include it. So my proposal went back to negotiating, went back to the table, and said we don't want to.
I understand that. All I'm saying is,
if you want to send a proposal,
I would like to ask. We paid this as as the city presented. Let me finish.
Go ahead.
As he presented the bill to us, we pay it for a fee simple ownership of it, and then we look at the water rate not being so high and adjust our water rate on our raw down to what we're paying, or maybe we raise it up 100%.
It says right here, Commissioner, did you read that at the bottom?
I did, but why don't we ask? You're sending something over.
It says, you met with the mayor Tuesday morning. I met with him Tuesday morning. Did he give you an indication about this?
You guys meet together?
No, we did not meet together.
That was a joke.
Hey, matter
of
fact,
thank you for listening to you.
Each and every one of us has met with the mayor at least once.
I meet with him all the time.
No matter what.
Sure, I meet with him all the time.
He has said that we don't meet with him, we don't try to work this out. Each and every one of us has been over there. And met with the mayor, trying to respectfully work this agreement out.
How many times?
I don't know how many times. You tell me how many times you've been there.
I think we'll get off.
That's exactly, so don't do that. I'm just making the comment.
I will tell you, I've been over to City Hall.
But I would like to offer this to the mayor as he presented his bill, with the exception we have fee, simple ownership in the plat.
I'm not interested in that.
Why?
Because it's.
That is your guarantee water security for the county and for your, in your future development and for the people of the county. Why wouldn't you want that?
Commissioner Boff brought up some great points. And he said, why would we pay $11.4 million for something we don't know that we can use? This way, we're not responsible for it. And if we don't get water, we don't pay.
He told me you can use it. The Corps.
Yeah, no.
Right, but the pipe in.
If the Corps or the EPD or the Grand Poobah of Water says you can't use it anymore.
Live and let live is a rule right now.
And our taxpayers will stop paying for all water and they will no longer pay for it.
Right.
Just as Commissioner Boff said, why pay $11.5 million for something we're not sure is going to be there?
And
my proposal protects that.
Well, and
you're saying that should all the people off in our entire region if they don't let you use that
pipe. I'm saying that Commissioner Boff said over and over, why would we pay $11.4 million for something we don't know we can use? And that's what this proposal answers, and Commissioner.
But this proposal is planning on getting water through this infrastructure.
And if we don't, we don't pay.
You're going to pay 5 or 6 times that in your proposal.
If we don't.
5 or 6 times that you're going to pay.
But we're not going to pay $11.4 million and not get water when they collapse, as he said. I mean, didn't you say that? Didn't you say that?
But I didn't say that there couldn't be any answers which negate some of those objections. And
do you have an answer?
No, I have some questions. Counselor, if we were to get fee simple ownership, can you think of any legal advantages or others that that provides to us?
Yeah, staff and I, Mr. Chairman, have had some discussions with respect to that. I look at it from two different perspectives. I believe there is a sentiment that if we have an actual ownership of the physical structure, then perhaps in future permitting, we may have a little more horsepower with EPD if we actually have ownership of it. I think my position, and I hope that I have said this all of to each of you who have asked me, is that if it's untethered to a capacity allocation or the agreement to go in together and modify our permit, I think it is of less value, because to me the permit is everything. But it's certainly better than a leasehold, and it is certainly better than an unstated entitlement. So I'm not trying to split the difference here, but I will say there is some utility, I think, with respect to EPD future allocations if we do have a fee simple. But my position would be that if you're going to pay that, we might at least want to think about some cooperation on a joint permitting program.
We're partners in the infrastructure. We can be partners going to the EPD, the city, the county, asking for additional permits. We're working together.
So you want to join forces with the city?
Not joining. You've got to work together, do you not think so?
Well, I think this is working together, but I think it protects the interest of our taxpayers without putting $11.5 million out there not knowing it's safe. I would rather know that we're getting water, if there's a problem, that we can then get our own intake and be done with it, and not have wasted $11.5 million on a permit the Corps says we can't use.
Well, Mr. Tam must have agreed this to an extent, because he asked him to go ahead and send it over on January 5th, and they sent it over January 6th. So, I mean, if I make a motion to
since you mentioned me by name, I asked for it, and I went and picked it up January 5th, so we would have a starting point to talk about water.
And you must think it's a starting point, so you can't be totally against as much as Mr. Bell is.
Well, that was in January, and this is after a tremendous amount of effort.
To start this all off, I'd like to make a motion that we send this bill back over to the city, asking for fee simple ownership of the raw water intake structure that was the subject of this invoice, invoice number 201-201-050719. Bill date was 1/05/2012, which according to this bill is now past due. It was due on 1/20/2012 for the amount of $11,436,450.13.
I think Grant and Nydia made that.
With a response by the city within 2 weeks from today.
Now, is that in any way tied to an allocation?
In addition to my motion, that based on this, it gives us 104 MGD, raw water intake capacity, capability, at 65% of that for the longevity. I mean, there'll become, gentlemen, motions, but there'll become a day.
You need a second before you discuss.
I understand. Okay, I'm sorry. I'll second.
I'll second for discussion.
Are you suggesting that we buy an $11.5 million capital investment, not knowing whether it's going to be used in the future?
What you're saying right now is so off base. That would mean everybody in our region, everybody in our county, would just feather away because we'd have no support.
I'm just basing it on.
Well, that's what you're doing, a bigger if than the chairman did earlier.
This is the same if the chairman had.
Your if is no. You know it's not realistic because there was a time that you were arguing for us to do this.
But I have found, I think, a safer way to handle the taxpayers' money.
The difference of the money, based on your plan of the $51 million by the time you're paying 75 cents per thousand, is going to be off by almost $100 million. When you're talking about 11.
You understand in business, there's risk and reward has a direct correlation.
That is correct.
With no risk of the taxpayers' $11.5 million, it will cost us a little more on a monthly basis to utilize a structure we don't
have. A little more? A lot more. In the term of your contract, it could be over $100 million.
I'm not prepared to spend $11.5 million of taxpayer money at this time for something that we don't
own. Calculated risk.
I don't believe this is time to make calculated risk.
Everybody else around here that has pipes in it, lake relies on it, they put money in their infrastructures, and they are banking on it for the survival of their citizens.
So we're going to double our risk then? The city made a risk by building it. We're going to stack ourselves on top of that risk.
Don't vote for it.
I'm not. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. I want to make sure on the what I believe is the allocation point. What your motion would be to get fee simple ownership of that with rights of 65%.
The total
of now and in the future of the total capacity
up to the 104 MDG that they.
Does that also make us responsible for 65% of any repairs?
That'll be worked out in with that agreement. It probably would if you own 65%. But right now they build it into. Right now it's built into your 10 cents.
So we're going to be using 43% of it or 42%. But responsible.
It's built into M&O right now, so maybe that'll adjust the M&O down if you take it that way. But to raise it up to 750%, not to pay $11 million and give an extra $100 million over 20 years.
You are in business, and you've been very successful.
And I've taken my calculated risk, and they work out well.
If you own a landscaping company, you don't. But if you do, and you're buying 10,000 pounds of seed per month, you might be able to negotiate free fertilizer, right? You quit buying that seed.
They're going to raise the price of seed.
Exactly. So we're not committed to buying 1.6 billion gallons of finished water at $2.43 a thousand any longer.
And you don't like the way they're treating the seed company. Sometimes you just go build your own seed company and put them out of business.
Well, commissioners in the 70s should have done that, and they didn't. And we can't help that today.
I'm not arguing. I'm trying to be their partner. Well, I don't want to be the partner in the infrastructure. I want to go to EPD. I want to go to the corner. I want to work together for the future longevity and the best of both the municipalities.
That's a noble effort.
Why not?
Now, I do have to say, first of all, the top end number of the $11 million is based on appears to moved over time. I remember 2 years ago when we made an offer for a substantial percentage of that. The intake was reported to have cost somewhere around $15 million. Now it's 17. Earlier, I think I heard Brian say $20 million.
Well, I mean, you had those emergency pumps running, they had the intake.
That included that. No, I think we could it's around $17
million. Who paid for the 48-inch pipe from the intake?
We were talking about pumps when they came in.
Who paid for that?
We paid $800,000.
So, what's cost paid for?
There's a short section in that that the city wants us to pay 100% for, about 5,000 or 6,000 feet, and then we pay from there up to our plant. We ran.
Is that it? But that's included in this, is it not?
No.
Just the short section that they've added on for us to pay 100% where they connected to our pipe.
42.
The 42. But we had a 48 at Pilgrim Mill Road, and they ran a 42 from the intake and connected, and then switched to 216s back to their system.
So they're using some of our pipes and we're using one of theirs. It's kind of a fair exchange.
It was their pipes before, but it was the pipes we were using.
So
is their pipes before pipes we were using?
So what is it that we derated from the money we owed last time, Tim? Which was started off at about $9 million then, and then
the last proposal that we did,
it came down to about $8 million.
Then we thought we should get some credit for the $4.8 million we paid in 98. And there was a calculation or offer or request to get some credit for depreciation of our past capital contribution. That is how the last number a year or two ago was calculated.
Do you feel that we should no longer get credit for that?
I think it was on the table. If any of that's still being used, anything that we contributed, I mean, it's
I don't think they're using those pipes anymore. I think they've abandoned them.
The 216s they are, the intake they're not, but it really depends on what that 4.8 went toward. And then we also brought up that we ran the 42 that saved the city some money that could be, part of the negotiation.
So
we spent money also.
So, on the last one, is your memory that there was $4.8 million that we deducted from the top end number of our offer?
I don't think it was either a depreciated amount that we used. I'm thinking back a couple of years. Is that in the offer that we made? Let's see. That was drafted and sent a couple of years ago is what I'm trying to recall.
Can we call the question?
Second.
What is the question?
Well, we have a motion and a second on the table.
Stops this question.
Right. I will second before this question.
You have to call the question.
I just think we're kind of getting off track.
This is
what it is. Sorry,
call all the questions not debatable. Required or require unanimous approval though across four votes.
Call the question.
There's been a motion and second.
And
call.
This technically is a bill.
Wait a second. There's been a motion and a second, and there's been a call, but it takes four people to vote on the call.
To stop debate, it is going to take four of you to agree to stop the debate. Yes.
And I don't agree. We have a motion to call the question and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye. Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. Aye.
And the motion fails.
So we can still discuss it?
Yes, sir.
Would you, to the degree that I'm favorable to this offer, Todd, that you have, would you be? I think we should get some credit for what we've invested in the past. It's not exactly our fault that if somebody's not using it anymore, just like it wasn't our consideration to stop using the old intake, which is still there. And that's value that the county has paid for something in the past. And if it's not used, but we paid in good faith for it, I think we should deserve some credit for it.
First intake is decommissioned.
but again, then it's not being used.
The decommissions may be not being used, so old, and may not be used.
It may mean a lot of things, but it definitely means it's not being used. Just like the pipes may not be decommissioned, thank you, but they are also not being used. And the issue to me, the common point is the lack of use, not whether they were decommissioned in some formal or other manner. So my question to you is, to my memory, there was something like $2 million credit against the number that he had asked for, which would make this a $9 million offer.
And I'll share this with you. I feel like this is important enough to secure the water future of the county. This is. Have fee simple ownership. That to argue back and forth that every $2 million on a deal that's well over $100 million savings, and may possibly not get the acceptance of this over that, doesn't balance to me. Because if by having fee simple ownership, it'll sure help us, I believe, on the amount in which we ultimately pay for the raw water that comes through this infrastructure and for our employees.
But you're
and at that point in time, well, I believe it's that important. And also at that moment, it said you choose to accept it. I don't believe these arguments and these standoffs will stand anymore between the city and the county. I don't think we'll ever get this contentious again. I think we'll be more in tune to working together. And it's for the betterment of everybody, the county, city, and county citizens.
Commissioner, I still have concerns. You talked about securing long-term infrastructure to pull water out of the lake. And some of the things that have been said over time, the more I have dug into it, the more it has a little bit of credence, such as, are we going to be able to pour water out of the lake? Or are we going to need to go to the river one day? Is the Corps going to allow that infrastructure, even though they permitted it, are they going to allow it to be used to 104 MGD? Those are a lot of unknowns for $11.5 million.
For the next 50 years, I can't imagine we need 40 million. Look here.
I'm just telling you, so it's a lot of money.
The city invested in it, and it's worked out extremely well for them. Including the impact before that, worked out extremely well for them. And I don't see anybody that has an intake infrastructure in that lake that has been told you can't take water at it anymore. That had the permits removed.
I agree, that's unlikely. But the possibility is there, and it seems to me that it's more
true. It's not likely, which makes it.
But it's not likely, it's not possible. And I think it's more prudent to not invest in the infrastructure, pay a little bit more for water as we go, and be done.
A lot more for water.
Sure, Commissioner Bump was prepared to pay 30 cents a thousand last time we talked about this.
Sure, 75 cents a thousand, more than double that even.
It is, and we're saving $63 million over 20 years.
So $150 million over 20 years.
We don't know that, do we?
Well, we know that as well as
compared
we know
to 75 cents, 750 times.
And that's better than double.
I mean, percent higher.
Is that a vote on this thing?
You'll have to ask this guy, Chairman.
Can we vote on?
I would say, if there's no further discussion.
I've got 2 points procedurally then. With respect to the motion second, this is advertised as a work session. So I need to ask the maker of the motion, the second, is this considered time sensitive? Otherwise, this will have to
be. This is time sensitive, sir.
Will the second recognize that it's
time
sensitive?
Could we give him 2 weeks?
Okay, we'll let the record reflect that. Secondly, this is the sort of proposal that I'm going to allow if it is approved. I want to say this now before the vote so no one can accuse me of carrying which way after the vote's taken. That if a majority approves it, I'm going to allow it to cross the street with the instruction that it is non-binding and it'll have to be distilled into an IGA and brought back pursuant to our rules on how you adopt an IGA. Is everybody with me on that? I'm not going to allow it to go across. But I feel that a proposal across the street of any kind is a positive. But it's going to have to be come back here, and if it's going to be memorialized into an IGA to be actually binding on the county, it's going to have to follow our rules. Everybody understand?
We're not voting on
Commissioner Tam's proposal.
You're voting on Commissioner Levent's proposal, but that is going to require an IGA because you're talking about maintenance, you're talking about fee ownership, you're talking about an IGA.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. That passes 4-2-0. Commissioner Amos recused.
I'd like to make a motion that we offer for a 5-year extension of the finished water with a 5-year option with the price frozen at $225,000.
Can we get a little more detail on that?
Because what more is
I haven't budgeted for someone here, so it doesn't matter as well.
How much more detail do you want?
And you want it, that remains, I don't think we can discuss it. You want to, without having a second, I can't.
What?
You hear what he just put out?
A second for discussion?
Oh, you made a motion.
A second for discussion. Stays at 10 cents a thousand.
This
overall,
is, hold on just a second.
This, I want a whole package here. I want a whole package.
I'm making a finished, there are two separate contracts. There's three separate contracts, actually. This is for the finished water.
Guaranteed by or not?
What do you mean?
You have to guarantee by $1.6 billion, angle?
He's extending the contract as it is.
Extending the contract as it is, on an annual basis. I can show you where we don't have enough water.
I get it.
Rolling it back to 225 for 5 years with a 5-year extension option, 5-year option.
If I made that discussion, I
asked.
You have kids of them. That's perfect. I like it.
Put it down in my pocket. Where am I going,
sir?
With all due respect.
All due respect. So I went to the director of the water department and also Tim Merritt, who oversees that and understands a lot better than I did. I said, what is it that we use a year? And certainly put a safety net in there too, a little extra. 800 million gallons a day is way more than cover what we use, and the big spikes are in May, June.
Sure.
And then it goes a little bit down the summer. I don't know if it's because of rain or people are watering the yards a month for those few months.
Okay.
And then the big spike seems to come back in August, September. And in those spike periods, it's more like 400 to 500 million, but 800 would more than cover us so we wouldn't get ourselves in a jam. So I think that.
Let me ask you a question. So how much are we going to need in 5 years?
And it goes up 3%, 3%, 3%,
so how much
maybe
are you going to 4%. Need in 5 years?
I just added in with the 800 million, I just added in approximately an extra 40 some odd percent extra. So that would cover you 3%, 3%, 3% compounded for about 8 to 10 years.
Okay, can you, based on that formula, are you willing to say that you 100% guarantee?
I can't 100%
guarantee. That, wait a minute, that no one in this county is gonna run short of water.
You can't.
Why do you wanna do that?
Because he'll still sell, this mayor, because he'll still sell you the water if you need more. You're just not guaranteeing giving him more if you don't need it.
Okay. But what if you need it? You don't have a guarantee that he'll make it available. He does now when he gets another water contract.
Let's ask it in your agreement. With also the ability to furnish additional water as needed.
So how much do you want to buy a day? Or annually?
You can do annually 800 million gallons.
A day. Tim, what's that a day?
2.2.
Yeah, about 2.2. But it's not a day. You're only using that in the peak months, and you might buy 6 or 8 million of those peak days to cover what you need.
But you have no guarantee that you can buy it on those days, and 3, 4, 5 years from now.
Can you change your motion to where you have more on those days and less on others? What I don't want to do is right now we buy.
You just said you didn't want to screw up a $100 million deal over $2 billion. And I'm telling you, it's not worth running out of water over how much are we talking in the dollars and cents that he's talking about over 5 years.
We might come to agreement.
I mean, what are you?
No,
you're splitting the hairs here when you don't know for sure. In the 1987, when this thing was last. Or when it was drawn up, do you think they anticipated the kind of growth that we had here from 1995 to 2005?
We're going to have it again.
Maybe. You know that for sure?
Our county's going to
Are you speculating on real estate already?
Yeah, because we're on Highway 400, so it's a cash flow.
Not if we don't get more water.
That's why I want this.
That's right. Not if you don't get more water.
That's why I want this.
I voted for it.
Okay.
But I'm telling you, that doesn't guarantee you enough water.
Here's your chart for your spikes.
Show me the chart in 5 years.
But do we
Show me the chart in 5 years.
I don't have it for 5 years.
I do.
Okay. And it goes up 3%.
It goes up 3.5.
To what?
To enough that I'd say we should extend the existing contract to what it is today.
Make it
And reduce, okay. the, reduce the reduce the rate to 225.
I tell you what.
We're going to be at 13.
There's one more item coming up, and it may affect how I do or don't vote on your motion. And it's the next item on the agenda today. Do you mind if we take that and then come back to this?
No.
I do mind.
Yeah, I do mind. Because this has to do with water, and all that's going to do is inflame the situation.
Okay.
You don't need this if we work that out in my motion now.
You might be correct.
Then we're done.
That is correct. And especially if we go down there.
I want to tell you something. I sat at this table in 2007. Well, we went to court with the City of Cumming. We went to court. We lost. You know why we lost?
Did it go all the way through a full trial, or did they do a settlement?
I didn't say where it went. We lost. That's a fact.
By judges.
We lost. We lost. They sat here and said they'd take 9.9. We paid them 14.2. We lost. We lost.
Wait a minute.
And if you,
I don't think the City of Cumming sued us and we lost. I believe they're sued before. There was a suit by them before the election and we won that.
Then they appealed.
I don't think they did.
We gave 14.2% splash.
We
That's
did,
a fact.
But not, okay, because, but not because they sued us.
Nobody can split hairs like this group right here.
I agree.
Nobody can overlook stuff like this group right here.
We paid them 14.2%.
And say we did.
And during that time, I just want to tell you something.
I just said they didn't sue us.
I just want to tell you, I want to finish. During that time, watching the judge, he was searching for something. He was searching to see who was operating in good faith and who was not.
I would agree with that. They always do. And if who's being reasonable, who's not being reasonable.
If you can't sit there and say to him, hey, my formula guarantees water to the citizens of the county for the next 5 years. I think that's a disservice.
What judge are you talking about?
Whoever
that he's going to be talking to about
if we throw this into the court system. I mean, we have two choices. You either settle it or it goes to the court system. The State General Assembly doesn't do this for you. Either we settle it, goes to the court system.
Just because his position difference from yours doesn't mean, therefore, we need to start talking about we're going to court.
It's not that his position differs from mine. I'm challenging to see if he can. I asked him if he could guarantee that
and you turned whatever his answer was into, therefore, we're sitting in front of a judge right now. That's a total non sequitur. Why don't you argue? Non sequitur. Why don't you argue the value of your position and listen to what he has to say and either fight him on against him on the value of his position rather than blowing it into some completely goofy thing like we're going to court now?
Because if we don't settle the contract, we're going to court, are we not?
I don't know. You going to vote for that?
Yeah, and
it's a ways down the road, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm not planning on voting for that.
Okay, then why don't we work through this? Let me ask you a question. What is the difference if you reduce it down? Tim, do you have time to run this?
Okay.
If you reduce it down to $225,000, and you keep the consumption the same, if you take it down, you're taking it down. Now let's just call it what it is right now. Is the CPI going to 250?
250.
It's 250. We're talking 243. It's going to 250. It's been as high. It was 247 2 years ago.
Right now, 242.
242 is out the window. Going to 250.
I understand. I can't recalculate. I'm just trying to say right now you're paying at the 242, you're paying $3,940,254. So you're proposing we drop it 9%? Is that about right?
No.
It's a 250. If you stay on the same program, the CPI.
So you're dropping about 10, you dropped about 10%. Oh, I'm good. So you can take that number I read out and drop it pretty easily, you're better by 10%.
Okay.
Drops it down to about 3.6 is where about where it gets. Or
225 is
366. 3.66 a year. See, there you go. So
last year we spent 4.2.
And you're proposing.
Didn't we spend 4.2 on finish last year?
Bear with me.
But I'm totally.
You're going to do it for 5 year extension.
5 years.
And I don't want to vote for anything unless I know we're sticking with the same 10 cent broader water or property on the M&O.
I just have to tell you, Todd, for two different contracts.
I want to vote on that one. I'd like to vote with them.
So you want to tie them again?
I don't want to tie them again. I want to make sure that one's going to fly. Yours isn't going to fly, and then we're not going to vote on 10 cents. That's what I want to make sure happens. I don't want to vote on some high-dollar finished water deal when we can finish our own, and then not get the 10 cents when we do finish our own to save the money.
I think having voted on this, no. 10 cents makes sense.
So, of course it does. That's why I'm going to
lose it. Then make it part of your motion. Make another motion. But they're two different contracts.
And I don't mind, and I don't know if you even consider this or not, because part of my announcement proposed was going to be about 210. Hold on, hear me out.
Okay.
Paying them 260. 50 cents goes toward paying the infrastructure.
Okay, that's a rate increase.
You can pay cash. Or you pay some cash, and then it's almost like a way of financing it out.
Let me just try to say something. Your motion was that we would buy this,
yes,
and own part of it.
Yes.
That's a capital expense.
Yes.
So it comes out of what? Your capital reserves, right?
And they have it.
So
like
it's not a cash flow issue.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So if you start tinkering with the price, you may be tinkering with a rate increase. Anyway. Somebody's got to pay with that, and then you can't pay for it at a capital expense because it doesn't meet our books, right?
So you're two.
Right? They're still there.
I understand.
No, it's not.
Let me just follow up on that for a minute.
I'm not so sure.
Also, the fleet's a pretty thin capital reserve account, and we will have to adjust our capital improvement plan.
It also becomes an asset, which helps our bond and credit.
Can we turn it to cash?
You're turning this into part of my motion.
No, we don't want to do that. We don't want to
deal with this.
You're discussing it.
I was trying to make a point that my starting point was 210. Even though I had 50 cents built into that, we can't do that. But my starting point was 210 adding the 50 cents to it. So I'm asking is 210 acceptable? You said 225.
My motion is 225.
Mr. Chairman,
You want to do it? We'll do it.
We need to recess this one.
We'll ask them to get this.
We might have.
If we want to get in a bidding war.
We're getting close. Don't get condescending.
If we're getting in a bidding war, that makes sense.
Let me interrupt.
5 years.
Council, five years, five-year option.
There's a motion on the floor.
There's a motion on the floor for discussion.
A motion to recess will trump that.
We're in the middle.
How about if we vote on this one?
Let's just vote on it and be done with this and then recess.
Okay, just be mindful. You've got an advertised finance committee meeting at 3 o'clock.
Why would you do that knowing what we're doing today?
I didn't schedule it. I'm just telling you.
It's already scheduled. Motion to recess this meeting so we can enter into a finance committee meeting.
And then come back to this?
Immediately come back.
Is that a second?
That's a second. Because I don't want to vote on half of this and then not finish it.
We'll come back to that.
Of course.
We have a motion and a second to recess this so that we can have the finance committee meeting. There's no further discussion.
Let's discuss it for a while.
Have you discussed it or not?
Thank you.
Happy?
No, but I'm good.
Please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign.
You need to call the finance committee meeting to order and then an immediate motion to recess.
Okay. I call the Forsyth County Finance Committee meeting to order. Do I hear a motion?
Second.
I make a motion to recess.
Motion recess.
Motion recess.
Motion recess, yes.
Okay. Okay, thank you. Motion to reconvene the special council session.
We have a motion and a second. I second. We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign, that passes.
Thank you. Y'all are back in session.
Back go, ding ding.
Good lord.
Taking up three. Are they going to take the
Hold on, let me ask my wife.
Yes, Tony.
Yes, Tony.
I gave you that, just so you know that, don't you?
Hold on, Todd.
Are we back in session?
Yes, we're back in session.
You have a motion and a second.
Now, procedurally, does she need to reread the motion because we went into recess and then we came back?
Procedurally, no, but practically, yes. I would ask that she reread it so we all know what we're talking about.
5 years.
That would be a
5 years with a 5-year option or renewal, and then I believe I heard 225 per 1,000 gallons.
Well, so we don't know what the water's going to be in 5 years and looking at the well is not available to us. I just wrote this in my brain. Your motion may also need to have the city's going to work with us to increase permits with both of us. And we go meet the EPD and such for you.
We did that just 2 weeks ago.
We should all go together, have a video vision there, media there.
Well, let us know where you're going.
If they choose to come, I think this would be something you should probably do with this, and that the man will work with us for increase.
He went down there with sides. He went down there with Mr. Amos and I. He was good. My dude's asking.
Where'd y'all ask him to increase permits? Did y'all ask him to increase permits?
You know, I've been asked that question a number of times.
You haven't answered it yet.
And I'm going to go ahead and tell you, in the room where you're state elected officials.
I understand.
So no matter what I tell you, you're going to question. So no. Go ask them.
No. Oh, you're still answering.
Okay.
Only
let's go. Keep, let's stick to the
I wasn't challenging.
To the just, deal.
It's okay.
You keep, you started it.
Five.
We won. Just to let you know, that I'm not comfortable going 5 and 5 at the full $1.6 billion at the full rec rate. At some point, I'd like to have something in that comfort zone that our raw water side could be increased on our permits, but we're not continuing to buy so much finished from the city.
Sure. The problem with that is the city doesn't control the permit.
That's why I'm asking in this motion, or somehow we get them to agree that they will go down there to maybe reverse the permits. If their needs are less than ours.
Wait. You're drifting into another.
I know
how
I am.
Bring it back
the
to
five, I don't even know if they're going to agree to that.
Bring it back to the agenda item. You're going to the next agenda item.
I did.
You sure did.
But because they tie together. And if you handle that one first, this will help me a whole lot do what you want to do.
What I want to do. It's the right thing to do.
The right thing to do, gentlemen, is to adopt the proposal that you and I created and send it across the street.
That's certainly an option. You can send them two proposals and they choose from.
I got a
third
one.
Makes
three. I have a third one.
Are you done discussing?
Yeah, vote for it now because I'm not satisfied. I want to find a comfort zone.
Withdraw your second.
I'm trying to find a comfort zone.
I don't know what you're searching for.
I'm searching for more raw water in 5 years.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign.
Aye.
That passes. That fails. 3-1. Commissioner Amos being recused.
Mr. Chairman, just
I thought the motion was to call the question.
No, but I didn't hear a second.
There was no second.
Oh, okay.
Do you want to reconsider?
No, that's fine.
Mr. Chairman,
so you didn't want to do the 5 years on the finish for 225 with a 5-year option fail.
Right, that's correct.
Okay.
Mr. Chairman, if I might, it doesn't appear that the proposal that we put together is going to be accepted. I would like to make a motion. I've requested in advance each of you that we send that allows me to send it across the street as non-binding just to get some input on it. So I'd like to make a motion that we authorize the delivery of that proposed IGA to the City of Cumming with a cover letter from providing that it is non-binding on the site plan, just for discussion purposes only, and that the additional disclaimer that should the City of Cumming be agreeable, that it must be returned to the Board of Commissioners for approval by either four commissioners without a public hearing or three commissioners with a public hearing as provided by our board rules. I think this will also allow us to address a concern that we have never sent a full proposal across the street. Councilor?
And I'm sorry.
You know I'm a proponent of sending something,
so
yes.
This is sending it across the street, yes. with a cover letter that is not binding. So that's
and I'm going to second it with an amendment. With the same conditions that you put on yours to go over there, I would like to see the one I have and the one Mr. Tam has and send three of them.
No. You put your own proposal together and
I
then
said,
we...
No, wait.
And then we will vote to send it over separately. That is, let's not tie them into the
same...
We can
send them to separate binders.
Let's do it each individually and I'll vote for yours. We can send over 50.
Too much time. We're not time for that.
You've spent as much time yapping as we could have voted on it.
No, y'all have.
You're right.
And that's our job.
By the
well,
way, thank
not
you,
all
Jim.
That. Didn't mean that yet, but discussing.
There's no reason he can't attempt to make that amendment to your motion.
Well, I guess he's got that.
You seconded his motion.
With
and
my
now,
amendment.
And now are you making an
what
amendment?
Is your, can you make an amendment when you second, or just somebody else?
You can make an amendment when you second. You just can't use an amendment to defeat the purpose of the main motion.
No, so wasn't. I'm just adding to your proposal that Mr. Tam is also allowed to go over. Mine is allowed to also go over with the same terms and conditions of which you
that's
stated on yours.
Your
so the three will go over.
I'll second your amendment.
All right.
Okay.
And then
but
just three proposals.
Mine only received one vote.
You still send it up.
Got a right.
Mine
didn't get any votes.
Yeah,
no vote.
We can each send
you're
a
the
vote.
Winner so far. You got one.
I second your amendment.
Thank you.
Okay. All right. Well, let me stop. We've got a motion and a second. We've got a motion to amend that has been seconded. Yes.
To add the
proposal by Commissioner Tam and the proposal by Commissioner Levent as part of this package of proposals going across the street. Okay. Do we have for the record? I understand what Commissioner Tam's proposal is. Commissioner Levent, what's your proposal?
Well, that's what I was saying. We don't know it yet, so we couldn't
concur.
And we're in the middle of
I've had it before, and y'all wouldn't listen to it about 8 weeks ago. Whatever.
Councilor, mine would include the proposed IGA and the presentation.
All right, so mine's going to be for a total overall 25-year contract. The first 5 years is the 800 million gallons a year at 220 a thousand.
That's finished water.
Finished water. The same M&O fees based for the raw water, the 10 cents, or how they come up with that. It could become 9 cents, it could become 11 cents. It will have CPIU on both. And at the end of 5 years, every 5 years it can be, contract can be canceled with 180-day written notice by us.
I think every agreement has mutual cancellation clauses, Councilor.
They do right now. The way I understand this one, though, is that the first 5 years is not subject to being canceled. After the 5 years, it's got the 180 cancellation period, is what I'm saying.
About one part? Does Georgia law allow that?
Oh, yeah.
Does it?
Oh, yeah.
I can't
and the city and county will work toward additional permits in good faith.
Is it not a mutually cancelable agreement?
And
you stop. I'm just asking. Didn't you ask
first? First, you got a second, and then you have to do for discussion. In the middle of a motion.
You want me to follow the rules, but you don't want
I'm in the middle of a motion. You're in the middle of a presentation.
Go ahead, parliamentarian.
Thank you, sir. I guess that says overall 25-year contract. So
what happens?
What is there anything mandatory?
Second.
the 800 million gallons a year annually.
Forever.
And we can buy additional finished water if needed at the same rate.
So it's a minimum of 800, it's a minimum of 800 forever for 25 years. What happens after that?
We can still, even during that 5 years and additional 5 years, we can still purchase finished water as needed.
At year six, we do not have any requirement to buy finished water.
To buy as needed.
Okay, respectfully, I think you maybe spend a little bit more money for a little less water.
I think so too.
Because you kept the CPIs in there.
You may not be buying much to finish at all. Permits may change by then, and they may not. So we'll have the option contract to still go on. But can y'all second this for discussion?
I will second for discussion.
So the answer to your question is, at the sixth year, we're not having to buy a minimum, but we can still purchase what we need. We haven't got permits yet. But at year eight, we get lucky somehow, and we get additional permits both of us, and we have this pipe or not, have a different pipe. We don't need to keep buying the water. But yet we have the ability to buy as we need to supply the customers.
But I think you are.
Yours is going to go over there too. He may put a line in the trash can. It could love yours.
That doesn't matter. Okay. I'm just pointing out, you know, maybe it'd be best to consolidate to one because they're similar in concept.
That's correct.
But it's a little less water.
Can I ask if we could?
I agree with you. That's what I'm trying to tell you. I'll just learn somewhat.
I would rather have more water.
Gentlemen, could I ask that we remove your amendment, get back to sending that one across, and then you two, we can discuss merging yours together or whatever?
We might just merge ours together and have a deal today.
You might, but I'm going to go ahead and get that one motion taken care of.
I like sending off the amendment.
We still can. I'm okay. But we've got these motions and amendments hanging. Let's finish one up. Let's remove the amendments.
Can I hang it?
Let's vote on that, and then you two can go back to discussing it, and we can send it over.
So I'm going to remove it so we can send them over and come back.
Yes, we'll come back to it.
Remove the second.
If I remove it,
let's just vote
the concept is to vote on yours.
Yes. Then let them
see if you two can come to an agreement here
and
now.
We'll send it over.
If you do, then vote whether to send yours with it. If you do not,
then we just send that.
But first, we're going to vote on my amendment to his, and then we're going to vote on his motion.
I may withdraw my second.
Finish up one item. Then you two can discuss something.
No.
Create a proposal. We vote to send it over. I will tell you, if you want to send over an offer at $75 a quart, if you want to send that over, I'll vote to send it over.
Fair enough. So if you'll...
All right, I'm withdrawing my second.
I'll withdraw my motion for now.
The motion is just to send this over to the federal letter.
Well, I think we'll send all three of them. They're still working on that.
We'll come back to that.
But that's not his motion.
Okay.
We'll come back to that one.
Asterisk? So an aspirin?
No, I need you to take an Adderall.
This is
Patrick. This is Adderall. That's Jim. Do you want to send yours over, Jim?
Commissioners, to the extent that I know what's on the table right now, I believe that it is the IGA that has been circulated to you. Do you want to go over the terms of that IGA as part of making an informal, non-binding proposal to the City of Cumming?
I think that would be wise.
Okay. Do you want to do that, or do you want me to walk you through?
I'd like you to. You wrote it.
All right. What I would put together. Basically, as you know, we have two pending IGAs, one for raw and one for finished water. The proposed IGA from Commissioners Tam and Bell, and that is on the table, on the floor for discussion right now, basically takes both those IGAs and basically extends them subject to whatever I have indicated is modified. Okay, so they would continue to exist subject to these modified terms. Modified terms are that the raw water agreement would be renewed and extended for a period of an additional 20 years with a single 10-year option to renew. So if all the options were utilized, it would be a 30-year transaction. All terms of the existing raw water agreement would remain in full force and effect except for the following, and they primarily pertain to the price. The first year would be 50 cents per 1,000 gallons for our water. Second year, the same. Third year would be 75 cents per 1,000 gallons. Fourth year would be 75 cents per 1,000 gallons plus or as adjusted by the consumer price index for the Atlanta metro area. And every year thereafter, for the extent of the agreement, there would be such an adjustment. All right. The county would be entitled to purchase as much daily raw water as needed from the City of Cumming, subject only to the City of Cumming's ability to meet its own water needs for its own customers. All other terms of the raw water agreement would remain as they are. With respect to the intake cost that is the subject of the invoice, there would be no obligation at all for the county to pay. With respect to finished water, the finished water agreement would be allowed to lapse, with neither party having any further obligations thereunder, and it being agreed that all obligations by both parties have been satisfied. The City of Cumming will agree that it shall make available and guarantee to Forsyth County on an as-needed basis no less than 5 MGD of finished water based upon a 30-day average.
6.5.
No less than 6.5 MGD of finished water based upon a 30-day average, for which Forsyth County may purchase as needed at $2.43 per 1,000 gallons. The guarantee shall run concurrent to the terms of the agreement. In addition, there's an additional paragraph in this IGA. It says, commencing January 1st of 2015, Forsyth County will unilaterally institute a 5% residential water customer reduction off of the then existing residential water rate, to be followed a year later by an additional 5% reduction in the residential water rate, thereby resulting in a cumulative rate reduction to 10%. And that rate reduction must remain in effect for no less than one calendar year and may be unilaterally changed by the Board of Commissioners without further modifying the IGA, because quite frankly, that's the county, not the city.
Okay, we'll discuss that for just a second.
Exactly.
I mean, it may be, you know, if we have bonds that are eligible to be refinanced or paid down, that may be more advantageous, thus resulting in a rate decrease.
I agree with that too.
For the water, I mean, that's one idea. I'm sorry that we didn't talk about that before, but it just hit me.
Why don't you strike that, Councilor? I think that we should, at least I'll make it known that I would like to give the residential users a decrease based on the 60 some odd million dollars we're going to be saving. Because I remember when we refinanced some of those bonds, and 2 years ago we had them, they were all non-callable.
They were
right.
What they are.
Right. So if they can't call them, you can't call them.
So just
make
it,
it's,
I would like to be able to do that.
In addition, this is not a unanimous vote. Proposal.
No, it's just
sending a proposed letter that is not
right
approved by the board as.
It's not unanimous. Acceptable. It's nothing. It's not
that, in fact,
you're just sending one over with the intent that we're going to send others over as well.
It's non-binding and could not be accepted by the city.
You can even say that it's being sent over by Commissioners Bell and Tam, and not
because what I don't want to happen is that set the standard in which we're considering, because to me that's way too high. Just for the record, I want to say that raw water cost is way too high for me.
Two responses. To Commissioner Levent's question, the answer is yes, this is non-binding. I think that was in Commissioner Bell's motion, mm-hmm. and it is not binding. Commissioner Bell's question, I do need it to be from the full board, because okay. the benefit of a proposal
right.
coming from the county is to it come from the county.
Maybe you can put it the request up.
Yes, that's fine.
So are we, I believe that we're in the process of voting on the motion to send that proposal across the street.
You are, with these caveats, that the number of gallons per day under the finished water provision would be 6.5 million and not 5 million gallons per day, as is in the agreement, and the Forsyth County unilateral rate adjustment paragraph would be stricter. The maker of the motion agree to that?
Yes.
Second, agree to that?
This is clear that we're also going to be sending others over as well.
Todd, yes, we're going to do it right now.
I'm not sure, because I know what can happen.
I need that last paragraph just one more time.
That the Forsyth County unilateral water rate adjustment is stricken, we're striking the paragraph.
Yes.
You agree to that?
Yes.
Okay, well, then I think the record can reflect that, and y'all can vote on it.
All right, we have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, like sign. That passes unanimously with Commissioner Amos recused. Since I don't really know what Commissioner Levent went to get, or how long it will take, why don't we take a 5-minute break? Without exception, we'll reconvene here at 3:30.
Is it recess?
Are they recessed?
Recessed.
You can't get up, Jack. Yes, they see. You may lose your seat. I mean, we can't put names on the seat.
Seat safe.
Seat safe. Listen, I call seat safe.
So, Dave, you think we're down right now? Pass one.
This was what happened in 2011. It don't mean anything. So this is just the 2011 pattern, and we had a wet month. It's only reason this drops next year. Next year it may be up over here.
Have you got these numbers in an Excel spreadsheet?
I do.
And that if you like it, you can send them to Excel.
What you do, but you want to raise
isn't that great?
Is that correct?
That's a contract.
The price doubles and the gallons double. So that makes it four dollars.
This is my time.
Yeah, Mary Dalton told me he thought about it, but she told me he changed his mind. It wasn't.
I can call the meeting back to order.
That's the point.
I'd like to call this meeting back to order. It's a little later than what I said, but it's now 3:40. PM. We're back to order.
All that order.
Yeah, back to whatever order we were in. And Commissioner Levent, will you finish describing your proposal?
I think we're coming back. We pulled it off the table. And we everyone's going to fly. I'm trying to work halfway between mine and Mr. Tam's just in case that didn't work out.
Okay.
I don't know that it's going to because we're still at odds of buying water on days that we don't need it.
Well, why don't we do three proposals then?
Fair enough. We'll send three over. You want to do yours first, please send over?
Mine was as simple as it can be, which is a five-year extension on the finished water with an option for 5 years more at a fixed price of $225 a pound. That's pretty simple.
And we're all water still the same.
It's a separate contract. That's five or six times I've said that.
Would you put that in a proposal form as well to send that?
What, the raw water? I'd support leaving. I mean, I've already made my motion. It's already failed, but I support leaving the raw water the same. I'm not, you know, going to make another motion afterwards. We jack up the raw water. If you're going to do this, I think it covers you. And, you know, you have to have, you'd rather have a drop more than a drop less. If you're going to talk to companies about moving to the county, they can't come here and say, well, we think the City of Cumming might sell you enough water if we run out. You know, this contract has been beat to death over the year. It's been to the board several times, and you know, people harp on the guarantee that we have to buy water from them. But the fact of the matter is, they have to provide to us. That's a guarantee also. And there's been times, correct, when we needed the water. Director of Water and Sewer shaking his hand. We had to have the water. So if you want to reduce, I mean, your proposal respectfully kept the CPI on there. Mine doesn't. How do you know what the CPI is going to do? How do you know for sure what it's going to do? So if you leave it at like this, at 225, you know exactly what you're going to pay, you know exactly how much you're going to have to buy, and it's the same price as Fulton County.
So you're saying it has no CPI or no CPI?
That's no CPI. 225, fixed price, 1,000, five-year option. We buy two million gallons a day from Fulton County when we need it. If we think we have too much money, I'm sure Fulton County would, you know, probably find another home for their water.
Is that part of your motion?
I thought my motion was before it failed. I just thought we were going ahead and setting it over.
Is that part of your proposal to send that money to
Fulton? That's all it is.
Send some money down there?
Yeah, because we have too much.
I didn't say money.
My
proposal is again is very simple. 225 for 1,000, five year option. We guarantee to buy, they guarantee to sell. There's the chart back there in 2016 at a 3.4% annual growth rate. There's 177 days we need water.
They hit about 21, 22 million gallons.
That's projections. That doesn't include the drought. That doesn't include the moon falling out of the sky into Lake Lanier and soaking up all the water. A larger growth rate.
Commissioner Tam, that was a motion, and were you agreeable to that motion containing the same language that Commissioner Bales did, that preliminary language about it being non-binding, and is it time sensitive?
I am agreeable just to get it across the street. We have a water contract that expires in 5 or 6 weeks. This water contract, since I've been on the board, first came here in 2006, 2008, 2009, 2010. It's been here. And now it's time to send something over there.
Well,
we sent
stuff over there before and was never responded to.
It's not my fault. So let's send it over again?
Yeah. In fact, I wasn't even implying fault. I'm just saying
we've got an announcement that was made that if the contract expires, the raw water rate will go up. That's the that's been communicated to us. So my proposal is try to keep things, you know, we run around and say we don't know what the Corps is going to do. We don't have their report yet. Don't know what EPD is going to do. We don't know what the Tri-State Water Board is going to do. But we do know that we have a source of water. And there are, you know, while there are some people that feel we may be paying too much for it, we don't want people to not have the water either. So we have to find some common ground. This proposal reduces the price, keeps the price fixed, but guarantees that we have the water available to us. It's the same price as Fulton County. Nobody's yelling about not buying water from Fulton County.
I don't believe their contract is about to expire.
That's right.
So that's why nobody's yelling about it.
Oh, no, people been yelling about city kind of work just like thoroughly.
Because it's 5 years, it's a 5-year option. Is there anybody sitting here saying that we don't need to find a source of water after May 27th?
Need to find it now.
No, but after May 27th, does everybody agree we have to have water? Do you agree?
I do agree.
So this contract, this is just an extension. It's as simple as it gets. And over the next 5 years, you never know what's going to happen. Corps, EPD, it's a price reduction. It's guaranteed. There's no CPIU.
Is that your
motion? All right. So that's your proposal. And Todd?
I think I got a second, Council.
I'm sorry.
And I'm not sure they'll accept it.
I thought the second was to send it across the street. You're not seconding that proposal?
I'm seconding that we send that proposal across
the street. All right.
Yeah, no, I'm not saying that. We'll send it across the city council.
All right. Who made the motion to do this?
I did.
Richard Day.
Are you clear on it? Did I ramble too much?
Yeah.
225.
225.
5 years.
5 year option.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
You got it right, Councilman.
And I wanted, yeah, and time sensitive with your preliminary language.
With the same
preliminary language. Thank you. Okay.
Now, we haven't voted. We might get more votes. I don't know.
Is your motion to just do yours or to do any other ones that come up?
My motion is for this now. I'm going to vote. I don't think I'm going to vote for anything. I'm not going to vote against sending anything across the street.
I'll present mine now. Send the roll.
Do we need to vote on mine?
Yeah, let's vote on one proposal at a time, if that's agreeable.
We have a motion and we have a second to send this particular one across the street in a non-binding IGA with the same words or same approach that was used for Commissioner Bell's. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed, like sign. That passes 4-0 with Commissioner Amos recused. Commissioner Levent.
Boy, I'm going to take the CPIU out and see just because it sounds so great. It gave me a great idea. If you don't mind. Brian Tam.
As long as we get a water contract.
Mine has the same preliminary language Mr. Bills did send across the street.
Thank you.
It's for 25 years, five-year renewal periods. Each five-year renewal period will have a 180-day cancellation. It has to be a written notice by us. If we wish to exercise that cancellation period, right? First 5 years, finished water is going to be $220,000. The guaranteed amount we buy is 800 million gallons on an annual basis, with additional finished water being available at the same $2.20 per thousand, and the raw water at the same rate it is today, covering the O&M.
Are you done?
No,
I have a question.
No, I'm done. As far as I'm concerned, it can stay like that.
Okay, so
throughout the whole 25 years?
$800,000 a year, $220,000 for 25 years. So it's basically just taking our existing contract, reducing the price to $220,000, reducing the commitment to $800,000.
That's correct, but yet we still have available more for.
But no CPI.
But I think you're going to have to speak in terms of specifics when you say additional. You know, we've bought as much as 9 million gallons.
No,
well, they know that. They know the risk.
It's the same as what it is now. There's a minimum purchase.
Listen, you go to any store, any artworks, any store, they know what the inventory is. They know what goes off the shelf. They know what they need to restock. Almost not to a T.
Hold on, folks.
But they know what's used somewhat.
Okay.
They know what they get it.
We're going to buy a minimum of 800,000 a year. 800 million, I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
How many is that a day, Tim?
That's
two and a quarter.
If you become water independent, cancel the contract.
But it's 800 minimum. We can buy more. Same as the contract we have now.
2.2 a day.
Round it up.
So that's what we have.
At 220. No CPI.
No CPI.
I just think.
If all at the existing.
I just think at some point you're going to have to get into the specifics when you say more available. I mean, if your Tyson's wants to go out into the county and open a place and they want to know, you know, if they can have 1 million gallons worth of finished water a day.
This contract can every 5 years cancel, be revoked.
We don't want any more chicken plants.
I want to open the world's largest car wash.
They only be a 5-year contract, maybe a 10-year contract.
I just think, though, that at some point you have to get into what additional water made available exactly means.
And they may say, if they choose to answer mine, then maybe they'll put that in there.
Okay.
Starting point.
Okay.
So is that your motion?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. We have a motion. I'll second that. We have a second.
Yeah.
And that's to send this, is that to vote on this proposal or to vote to send it across the street?
It's to vote on this proposal to send it across
the street. Okay.
It's the same manner as the other two previous proposals.
Yes, that's correct.
So I second that. So we have a motion and a second. Is there any further discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. That passes 4-0 with Commissioner Amos being the chief. All right, item number two.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
First of all, I'd like to address this with the clerk. We've had, at this point, as I count them, 4 different items that have been approved. We've got the $11 million proposal. We've got the IGA from Commissioner Bell, the IGA from Commissioner Tam, and the IGA from Commissioner Levent. Are all of those motions, were they time sensitive?
Yes.
Yes. Well, I need to.
Do we make a motion to make them all?
I'm getting, we may need to. I just want to check.
I'll make a motion that all the 4 preceding motions were time sensitive.
Because I don't know that yours was time.
Mine was actually fine.
I
whispered that nobody
heard.
I did.
How can you possibly whisper something nobody
hears?
We have a motion and a second to make all 4 items to be sent across the street, sent in a time-sensitive manner. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. That passes 4-0 with Commissioner Amos being recused. Now,
last item,
yes,
on this agenda topic is the invoice itself. Mr. Chairman, at this point, you know, we've had an invoice. We got it on January 5th. I believe our county manager responded to the invoice on January 17th, and I'm mindful of why it was sent across the street. I get that, and I'm not trying to over-lawyer the invoice, but the proposal we're about to make, notwithstanding, I do think that we need to at least deliver something across the street that formally addresses the invoice. Irrespective of what our ultimate settlement or compromise may be on it, I think that's only fair, and I think there is, I just think it's appropriate, and it's a reasonable thing for us to do. That would be my request, is that you all provide authorization. I do.
And you're going to work with something? To the extent that we don't have an agreement, we don't feel like we owe it except for if we come to an agreement on the piece of ownership, we're willing to pay.
Mr.
Chairman, I make a motion that we authorize County Manager to deliver to the City of Cumming a letter stating that the county is not presently in a position to authorize payment of that invoice for $11.4 million. That at this time we don't feel the county has a legal obligation to pay that invoice, but as part of an overall order contract negotiation that we will be interested in considering payment as part of a compromise on the order contract.
And I would request that be time sensitive.
And I would make that time sensitive.
Thank you.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. That passes 4-0 with Commissioner Amos being recused. Thank you, Counselor. Now, is there any chance we can go on to item two?
Can Commissioner Amos come back to that one?
No, though.
No, no, no. You're still in time.
I'm waiting for you, Paul.
I'm going to go ahead and say that I don't think, no matter what you do, you're going to get a response by May 27th. And that by doing this, maybe throwing or making a delicate situation difficult.
I agree.
And I think we ought to postpone this.
Postpone this item here.
That's item number two. Until we've got a contract that expires 27th, 26th. Work session on the work session. The first work session in June is the 12th.
Right. Of course, if you send this and you got a favorable response, obviously it would change on negotiation.
That's exactly right. But like I said, I don't think you get any response in 5 weeks. Do you really think somebody's going to stop what they're doing downtown and say, oh wait, Forsyth County wants to change their allocation?
No, for the future. We understand we're not going to work that fast.
Okay, so
sudden though we might as well get it started. We should have done this 2 years ago. A year ago.
You think it's going to be done right in the middle of negotiations?
Yeah. I think you're in the middle of negotiations. Again, if and when we ever go to court, if we were to go to court, do you think this is operating good faith?
I think it's operating in the best interest of the county.
So yeah, it is. It aligns itself.
I think at this time, you have to postpone it until May or June the 12th.
Why don't you make a motion about that?
Well, I do.
It aligns itself with the bill that was sent over.
Second.
Matter of fact, not even second. With the bill. According to the bill, we should have $24 million a day, but this is only asking for 21. Seems very good faith.
We have a motion and a second.
65%.
Todd, we have a motion and a second.
On.
Postpone it? June the 12th, which is the next work session after the water contract expires.
Is there any further discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign.
Aye.
Aye.
That's a procedural motion. That's defeat.
Therefore,
can I make a motion, sir?
I would like to make a motion to send this resolution to over to the city.
Why don't we? I said it. The city. We're voting
town. I'm sorry.
We're voting
to the EPD.
Here.
To the EPD.
The resolution requesting Georgia Environmental Protection Division reallocate the existing surface water withdrawal permits between Forsyth County and the City of Cumming. It's no different than what the bill they said. They said we're 65% users. This doesn't even ask for that much.
Do I hear a second?
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 All those opposed, like sign.
Aye.
And that is 2-2.
That is that's a substantive motion, a main motion, and therefore the tie works to move it to the next agenda where the tie can be broken. Which would be whenever a fifth member can vote on this topic.
Okay. I I believe that then will take us to item number three, Forsyth Sewer Agreement.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, this is my fault. Y'all are even having to revisit this again. This was a matter I brought to y'all at Tuesday's work session that was just a sewer reservation agreement based upon a letter of intent from last year. You approved it to go forward and go ahead and be executed, but I forgot to mention it as being time sensitive, and I need it to be time sensitive because it is.
That's all you need is a motion to me.
Yes, sir.
The previous approval of this to be time sensitive.
That's correct, Mr. Chairman.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote. Please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. Data passes unanimously. Item number four, reduced price alcohol sales.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, presently the Forsyth County Alcohol Code contains verbiage very much like that is in the back of your agenda packet, section 6-138, involving happy hour promotions. Now let me first of all, as I begin, say this is not about any request by any commissioner to authorize happy hours. But the way this provision in the alcohol code is interpreted by support is it also precludes any reduced price selling of alcohol anywhere within the county. For instance, we have had situations in the past where someone has wanted to do maybe a Mother's Day special, where if you come in and you buy a couple of dinners, they might give mom a glass of Chardonnay for free, or perhaps a reduced price drink on a one-time event basis. And we don't allow that. In fact, the language says no licensee may serve discounted drinks, number one, or increase the volume of alcoholic beverages contained in a drink, or otherwise not charge a customary price for alcohol. So I think there has been some concerns raised that while certainly we understand the policy behind happy hours, which can present some real issues from an enforcement standpoint and perhaps for an excessive drinking standpoint, sometimes maybe the reduced price prohibition may actually be costing us some market share to other jurisdictions that do allow that and some other things. So I thought the feedback I got was it might be worth at least a board discussion about this.
The discount group or specials, are they allowed at all for a longer period of time out of the county?
No licensee may serve discounted drinks, period.
Not even for a week long?
Does
a week long constitute or nothing?
No, and you're raising a good point. How would they know? And it would be a fact question. What is the market price for that beverage, and are you charging less for it?
Is that government interfering in
price? It's government attempting to say that perhaps charging below market alcohol might yield public safety concern, perhaps. Well, I mean, it's no different.
That'd be the happy hour.
Why not have a full happy hour?
Well, we don't want to change happy hour.
Why not? That's government interfering with stuff.
Yeah, but happy hour, in my opinion, people come off the road in the middle of traffic hour, drink X amount of drinks real quick and get back on the road again. I'm not interested in that.
Well, that's government.
But if mom wants to come in and get a glass of champagne on Mother's Day, I don't see how we get in the middle of that. If they were off that special for Mother's Day, I don't see how we get in the middle of that.
Do I hear a motion?
How do you fix one without the other?
How do you say what now?
How do you fix one without the other? I don't want to interfere. I know right now we don't do happy hours.
The typical definition of happy hour is typically buy one drink and get another drink free, or perhaps it might be buy one drink and get a double shot.
All within an hour or two. And that's right. The problem, because you're rushing them to drink real fast in that short period of time. And my fear is that's when they drink way too much and they get right back on the road again.
You know, but the same falls for the same mother. You have a Mother's Day special.
She gets one with her meal.
Well,
she eats two meals.
City of Alpharetta used to have one.
They say you eat more food than any of us.
City of Alpharetta used to have one where it said you could reduce the price of the drink if you reduced it all day long.
Correct. All day long.
So that seemed to work pretty well. You know, if you did
green beer.
Bud Lights, green beer for $1.95, as long as you did it all day long, just not 4 to 7.
Yeah. Not a short window makes it.
You can make it free all day from others, Robert?
For opening up?
Green beer?
For 12 to 12
o'clock? One free drink for moms?
That's it. But
mean, that would meet your need there.
If that's the only one going for, I just don't think that you tell them they can't have them. One particular drink special for all day long.
You could do one penny, excuse me, glass of champagne all day.
So are we going to have the cop come in and say her license doesn't show she's a mother, therefore I have to?
It's up to you. I don't think you can discriminate just to mothers. I think you have to say.
I'd like to do that.
This article is raised, they're priced at this price all day.
That's the easiest thing to do, like you said. It's easiest. One beer, one glass of champagne.
They'll have people doing Jack Daniels Day. They'll be doing bottle beer day. They'll.
I agree.
Ladies night, Tanqueray nights.
Yes. But one all day, not a short window.
No way they can drink all day.
They don't drink all day. Some drink for 5 hours a night.
Do I hear a motion?
How would you want to work? So what are you going to do? Bring it to a public hearing?
It's up to you all. I mean, I'm.
Put it at public hearing.
I like Commissioner Tam was saying.
His idea of the, how would you work that?
You're allowed to discount alcohol.
For certain products.
Beer, wine, or alcohol. Beer, wine, or alcohol for all day.
All day, open to close.
One item.
One item, open to close.
Or one category of items. If it was bottled beer, for it. Yeah. If it were.
Open to close.
You know, white wine. What if it were like
that? Is that a way of motion?
That's what you want, yeah.
That's his motion, I'll second it.
Now, this is a motion to bring this to. To ask that to be brought to.
Draft the language and bring it to public.
Yeah, and I think you'll see some, you know, restaurant owners come speak one way or the other.
Well,
I'm afraid they're over county lines now.
Do they like that or not like it? Will it help business?
I think it depends on some of their concepts. I mean, there are some restaurants that are heavy food. There are some restaurants that are heavy alcohol. You know, I think if you're, for example, I know that Cinco de Mayo, our Mexican restaurants would like to run
margaritas
at a reduced price all day long, or Mexican beer, you know, Tecate's or Corona.
But a restaurant is not going to oppose something like this. It's just their choice. It gives
I don't
option.
Know if they would or not. To be honest with you, there might be some that say, look, my crowd is rowdy enough already. I don't know.
But they don't have to.
I want to sell less alcohol, and I want to hide because, you know, there are some that say you have too many bar customers that run away the dining room customers.
But they can make that choice. They don't have to offer.
They don't have to. That's right. That's a good point.
Be up to each individual bar owner.
Unless we mandate that on Mother's Day, yeah. Every restaurant has to have.
No, this is optional.
Right.
Anyway, public hearing, we have a motion. We have a motion, we got a second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion.
There is discussion. That's okay. A good point. Because, you know, there are restaurants that, you know, let's just say you had an Irish themed restaurant on St. Patty's Day that would raise their drink prices for that day because they expected a larger crowd. So I think that's worth addressing. Are we allowing that as well?
What do we care?
You know, New Year's Eve. Are people going to raise their price?
Let them.
Do you care?
I don't. I think we just think the
free market.
It's not just discounting, it's price adjustment.
No, we're not going
to
get
we don't speak to that at all.
No.
Okay.
Let me, when you say we don't speak to it, are you, I think what you're saying is that today, before we vote on this particular thing, if I own an establishment, I could announce I'm charging more on a particular day than I normally do. I got to tell somebody.
You can charge $10 a day for $10 for a glass of beer if you want to. No one's going to buy it.
But tomorrow it goes back to $5.
Yeah. You can run your customer off again.
We don't set prices.
We're not. That's like a hotel race. No,
but the ordinance currently speaks to the pricing needs to be consistent.
That's correct.
Well, it's
going to go one way.
It speaks to that within the notion of what the ordinance says is if you begin to add more alcohol to your drinks, then you have got to raise the price of that drink proportionate to the price customarily charged. And the term customarily charged means what's charged over a week.
That's the week I'm talking about.
Right.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no Are you satisfied, Brian?
He's good.
If we have a motion and a second, if there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, like sign. That passes unanimously.
It comes to a public hearing, correct?
It does.
Yes, sir.
Is there any further discussion or information to come before this board? If not, do we need an executive session?
We do not.
Do I hear a motion to adjourn?
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. That passes unanimously, and we are adjourned at 4:10.
And we will reconvene.
The Finance Committee needs to reconvene.
It's 4:15. Yeah, that's $100 for you.
It was broken.
You know?
You don't need it. You have those.
Tam.
Are you staying?
Oh, are you doing that now? Yeah, I signed it, but I laid it down.
Can you just give me a call?